Greetings, Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020 friends. In this tutorial today, I'm going to be working with three different types of scenarios. I'm particularly going to focus where rivers, lakes, and ponds are missing. If you're not accustomed to building scenery in Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020, it may seem intimidating, but it's really not that difficult to do. Once you understand a few basics, then you'll be ready to take off and build scenery on your own. Now, I'm not going to go over the basics in this tutorial. However, if you look at the description below, find the Show More button, tick on the Show More, and the first thing you'll see is a tutorial series that I put together that teaches you how to do the basics. It will teach you everything you need to know to get started. In fact, everything you need to know to do what I'm doing today. And you may want to watch this video and see if this is something you have an interest in doing. And if you do, you can go through the 20 minutes of tutorials and come back and do the work as I've done today. And now I will begin. Before I upload each video, I go through the video and mark timelines to set chapters. And I do this to make it more convenient for the viewer. Anytime you're watching one of the videos, you can drop down to the description, tick on the Show More, and as you roll through the Show More, it will have pertinent information like the Patriot Six Channel, the Patriot Six Scenery Group, Discord, any videos that I believe are relevant to the subject, and then you get into the chapters of the video. This is the subject content, and here are the basic tutorials. You can skip around, or you can come back and find a chapter that you may need to rewatch later simply by ticking on the number, and you will immediately go to the chapter that you selected. Welcome back, and what we're looking at right now at this point is a pond, and this pond is located to the entrance of the subdivision in which I live in. So I know a lot about this pond. I see it every time I drive in or out of the subdivision. But if we take a close look, there's no water. It's just a blue image. And the blue is accurate because they do keep the water blue. And something else I see that is inaccurate here, there are trees generated where there are no trees in real life. And there are trees missing where there are trees in real life. So let's clean this up and make it look better. And I am in developer's mode. I'm going up to the developer menu, editors, and I'm going to open the project editor. And a project editor opened without the inspector. So down on the project editor menu, I'm going to view an inspector. And now I'm going to the Project Editor menu, Project, and Open Project. And it navigated to the Working Scenery folder, which is a folder I use for all of my work. And if you watch the tutorials, you will understand. And I'm going to Test Package. And this is just a scenery folder I use for tutorials. I'm going to drop down to the bottom XML and Open. And now I'm going to drop down to the BGL on the project editor. And up on the inspector, I'm going to load in editor. I'm going to remove the materials for now and give it time for all the scenery objects in my scenery library to load in. Now the scenery library has loaded in, and there's many ways to attack this, but the first way I'm going to attack it, I'm going to remove the trees around the pond so I can see the pond better, and also so that I can replace the trees accurately as opposed to this mess we see here. And to do that, I'm going up on the objects window, and I'm going to change from scenery to polygon. I want to make sure, as far as I can tell, I'm straight over the top of the pond. And now I'm going to add a polygon. Alright, the polygon is complete. and the properties window is up. I typically keep it over here on the inspector to give me more window space. But if the properties window does not come up for you, then you will go down to the scenery editor, tick on view, and tick on properties. And now with the polygon selected, I can tell that it's selected because I can see I have it selected in the scenery editor. And up on the properties window, I'm going to vegetation, tick on it, and slide the top slider all the way down to zero. And now we can see the trees as they really appear. Now I'm going to build another polygon, and this polygon is going to be the polygon for the pond. You'll have the most success with the polygon if you stay on top of it using the developer camera and follow the polygon around. And this will make sure that you don't have any perspective issues when building the polygon. So let's build a polygon around the pond. Now I have the pond polygon complete. And I made one little mistake here, so let me drop down and fix this. We'll tick on that point. Sometimes it's hard to tick on the point, but if you tick on the polygon and keep ticking, you'll finally get the point. I do not use terraforming for lakes, ponds, or rivers. I find that the terraforming creates more issues than it helps. So I stay away from terraforming when it comes to building water. Remember, I keep the properties window over the inspector, so it can get a little confusing if you're not used to looking at it. But I'm going to go to water. We can use water, we can try pond, but I don't see much difference in the two. You don't want to use ocean because that's just going to sink it down in the ground and that's not going to look well. All right, now we have the water, and the water is blue as the water should be. So now let's fix the trees. I'm okay with the trees being thick all out in here. It's here that I don't want the trees thick because that's not the way it is in real life. So I'm going to make another polygon just for the vegetation. And I could go on forever, but I'm not going to. I'll quickly do this area. Okay, that should be good enough for a tutorial. Although you can see there's plenty of trees that are not generating out here for whatever reason. So, on the properties window, I'm going to go to vegetation. And you see the trees start to spawn in, so you just pick the amount of detail and the scale you want. You can lower or increase the scale with the top slider, and the density with the second slider. So I'll just make it dense. And now let's build some single trees. Up on the objects window, I'm going back to scenery, tick all, and type in the word tree, and look for a tree that works. And we have lots of choices. I'll go with oak tree because we have a lot of oak trees here in Tennessee. See how this looks? Larger than I really need for this area, but I'm ticked on it, so I can go over to the gizmo to scale. Tick on scale and scale this tree down. And I'm just going to duplicate this size. Go back to translate and move the duplicates around. and continue to duplicate and fill in this area. And if I want to do it more quickly, I can look and see where it says the scale is 0.4. So up on the default scale, I can change that from 1 to 0.4. And now I can one tick place by using the one click placing button. Now that looks more like what I see in real life when I drive through. So let's go ahead and save the scenery down on the scenery editor. And let's move to scenario number 2. Scenario number 2 is a man-made lake. This is about 100 miles up the road in Kentucky, something I've driven by many times. So on the map, I'm just going to copy the coordinates. And on the tools, I'm going to the teleport window. And it dropped the teleporter over the top of the scenery editor, so I need to remember that. I'm going to paste in the coordinates and go to that location. And let's let the scenery generate. The scenery has generated in. And here is the lake. Although you see it's not a lake, but it is in real life. So up on the scenery editor, again, I'm going to polygon, and I'm going to build a polygon around this lake. Okay, the polygon is complete. So on the properties window, I'm going back to water. And I think I'll just choose lake since this is a lake. Although it doesn't seem to make a lot of difference between water, pond, and lake. Now we have a little problem here. Let's go ahead and draw a polygon around this island. And with the polygon selected, I want to exclude water. And I think I chose lake, so I need to exclude lake. All right, now let's go to the last scenario. As you can see, the water is a mess here. Let me show you a little secret. Let's build a polygon real quick right here, like so. And let's go to water. Let's exclude river. And look at that. There's a dam under there. But you can't see it because it's covered up with the water. So in a video I have coming up, I'll show you how I rebuilt this dam without any 3D modeling. And I simply did it with objects that are available in the scenery library. and I will show you how I did that in another video. Let's get rid of that polygon. Now it's going to take a polygon through here and a polygon here. It's going to take a couple of polygons. In actuality, this is above ground and not below ground. So matter of fact, let's take care of that right now. I'll make a polygon just for this little area here. And on the properties, I'm going to water. And I'm going to exclude, I believe this should be river. Now, there you go. Now that's no longer covered with water. Now let's build a polygon that we're going to use to fill the water in here. And now that polygon is complete, let's go to water on the properties. And we can leave it at water. What happens if we do river? Well, it doesn't cover it all up for some reason, so let's stick with water. I'm going to spin around and do the same thing here. And honestly, I'm being a little sloppy here. But you need to stay over the top of it if you want to be precise. Now the polygon's complete. On the properties, we want to go to water. And that's how water looks. And river doesn't do it, so let's stick with water. And there you go. There's three scenarios where I fixed water. And as I said earlier, I do not use terraforming on water because I think it creates more problems than it solves. So I hope this helps you. I hope you learned something from this and you can improve water in your locations. And you can also do the reverse and remove water where you don't want water, like over roads, etc. In a future video, I'll show you how I built this dam. And for those of you that haven't built scenery before or need to brush up on the basics, as I said earlier, go to the description below, tick on show more, and go through the tutorials that I built to prepare you to do the work that I did here today. This is Patriot Six. Thank you for watching. If you're not a subscriber, please consider subscribing because it helps the channel. Helps the channel to grow and for more people to see it. Then this is Patriot Six, and I will see you soon.